confessing that we did something wrong. You know? We did something wrong to lose that. We've got to constantly be more. Paul said, I'm filled with the Spirit daily. Why? Seemed like one time was enough. No. He said that we're like clay pots that have holes in them. The Bible says that Jesus said we'll be filled with living waters that will flow from our bellies. You see, you know, if the Holy Spirit, or if waters, let's do this, if waters were to just kind of pool up somewhere, what happens to water that pools up? It gets stagnant, doesn't it? You see these little old mosquitoes skirt across it. I mean, you know, nasty. Well, who wants to drink water like that? Who would be attracted to some stagnant pool of water? But you let a crystal clear running lit water that flows through, people naturally attracted to that. And that's the Holy Spirit of God. You see, it flows through us. And so we need to be praying to be filled daily. Daily. Confessing our sins. Daily confessing our sins is one of the hardest things for us to do, is to admit that we've done wrong. We need to be honest about our condition. Come clean. Tell the truth to the Lord. You see, He knows all that. Before we can ever recover that cutting edge, as individuals and as a church, we must come to that place where we can honestly admit, I just can't do it. Now, I'm one of those people, folks, will confess to you that I'm going to do it come hell or high water. You know, I've just got that kind of mentality that listen, I need to back up and say, wait just a minute. Lord, I'm not going to do this under my own power. I need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. And you lead, not me. Maybe it don't need to be done. Maybe there's something else that needs to be done more, but I need to be in touch with Him so that He can lead me and guide me. Amen? I'm just confessing to you. Is it okay? Don't place me up so high on some pedestal up there that don't think that, you know, I'm just a traveler along with you. We're trying to go to the same place. I just happen to be bringing the word. That's it. I'm trying to reach you. That's all. Just like you. Just a pilgrim. It also involves not only concern and confession, but also some common sense, folks. We need to know that the accident didn't belong to him. You know, he knew that. But we need to realize that that was such an important thing. You see, there's a story that illustrates this there in the Scriptures. The fact is, this person that lent this axe head to this man trusted him to take care of it. If you're loaning a tool to someone, a valuable tool, you're trusting that person to take care of that tool, aren't you? Jesus Christ, God, has given us, He's trusted us enough to give us His Holy Spirit. We need to be careful not to misplace it. And to use it. And to keep an eye on it. Amen?
Amen?
Just some common sense things here. May not seem that big deal to other folks, but folks, it's a big deal to us because we know the value of God's Holy Spirit. We know what Jesus Christ went through so that we might have the Holy Spirit. He gave His life. The power to serve the Lord does not come from our own human nature. It comes from the Lord above. The power to make an impact in this community doesn't come from our own imaginative ideas. It comes from serving Him with God's Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit that goes before us. It's the Holy Spirit that convicts people of sin. It's the Holy Spirit. It's His work. It's His church. It's His plan. If we're going to make an impact, we need to get involved with Him first. Talk about revival, you know. It's just revival. That's exactly what it is. that you lost it. Let's find where you lost it. It involves coming back, folks. We need to come back. We need to go back to the place that we realized, okay, as we do a search, we need to say, all right, well, man, this was going here. I was working under the power here. God's Holy Spirit is with me here. I remember that. I know it for a fact, but I can't remember much after that. We need to go back to that point. Okay. Go back to that point. Find where we lost it. It's the same. Maybe it's because of some sin. Some sin in your life has been committed. Maybe it's because your priorities have become misplaced. You know, I don't know what it is. It's different for each person. It's different for me. It's different for you. Whatever that point is, listen, it's His Holy Spirit that's going to reveal it to you. Even right now, it's right across your eyes right here. You know exactly what it is. If you're trying to undermine things in God's house, it's right there. You can see it. He's telling you right now what it is. If you've been gossiping, He's telling you what it is. If you've been negative all the time, He's telling you whatever it is. If you're addicted in some sin, you know, that's what it is right there. It's before you, folks. We don't need to talk anymore about it. The Holy Spirit's already revealed it to you. We come back to that point. So, okay, all right, Lord, all right, enough is enough. Sick and tired of being sick and tired, I confess this to you. Forgive me. Confrontation with the divine. You got to do it. It's coming face to face. When you do that, that's when you'll see a miracle take place. That young prophet, he went to Elisha. He knew the power of God on his life. He went to Elisha and said, man, you got to help. Elisha said, all right, let's go. He went back to that place, and Elisha told him what to do. You take and cut this branch. How is cutting the branch going to help me find that iron axe? He didn't question. He was just obedient, and he did it. The miracle took place. That iron axe floated to the surface. It floated to the surface. Now, listen, whatever it is, folks, that you need to do, listen, don't question the Lord. You just go and do it, okay? Just do it. It may not make sense to you, but do it, whatever it is. If you need to stand up, if you need to shout, if you need to kneel, if you need to lay face down, if you need just to pray, do it. If you need to sing, whatever it is, do it. Don't worry about what I think or you think or anybody else. Just do it, okay? Think about what God thinks and do it, whatever it is. If you need to cut the internet off, do it. If you need to turn the TV off, do it. If you need to cut your telephone line, do it. Whatever it is that's causing the problem, the Lord says to get rid of it, do it. Whatever it is, do it. And that's where we'll see a miracle. You see, when the church begins to deal with her sins, that way between us and the Lord then is cleared of all obstruction. Once again, folks, when Jesus is lifted up, the Bible says it will draw all men down. Do you believe this? But it also involves commitment. These young men realized